I think people are starting to wake up. I think people are starting to realize what's really important in life. I think there is a shift. I think more and more people are looking for different options. New generations are growing up with that thought in mind already, that a 9-to-5 doesn't really bring stability. The only thing stable about being unhappy in a job is just your check that comes every 2 weeks. It really is exciting because I think it's also what the world needs. Nature needs for all of us to start little by little waking up and finding new ways of life.
Afuera, pero el día que yo me muera, sé que tendrás que llorar.
Llorar y llorar, llorar y llorar.
Dirás que no me quisiste, pero vas a estar muy triste y así te vas a quedar. Con dinero y sin dinero, hago siempre lo que quiero. Y mi palabra es la ley.
No tengo trono ni reina.
Everything just started working in our favor. We had been dreaming about it for a long time, and we kept saving money and wanting to figure out how to make this dream come true. My name is Maria Galvan, and I am one of the co-owners of Porã Chacahua. I am 31 years old, and I was born in Guadalajara, Jalisco. The vision behind Porã is to be an eco-village where we meet and connect with people from all around the world and be able to do all this while taking care of the planet, recycling our waters, taking care of the trash and all kinds of wastes, and be as eco-friendly as possible. We want to start growing our own food. So we're gonna have a garden in the front. We're gonna have chickens as well, so we can have our own eggs. We just opened 2 months ago, so there's a lot of plans that we still have for this place. We wanna host yoga classes here, we wanna have retreats. I think we're doing really good with the internet as well. We're gonna have good Wi-Fi and have a co-working area. A lot of plans. This is just the first phase. But little by little, I think this year is when we're learning from trial and error what works and what doesn't work in the island. The town of Chacahua is at the beginning of the island, and we are about almost 3 kilometers from the town. So We're a little far, which allows to have a very peaceful place. It's not crowded, and we get to have the beach for ourselves. Chacahua is actually one of the few Afro-Mexican communities in Mexico. It has a long story of being very secluded from the rest of the country. For a long time, it was just a very small community living here. And now it's growing a lot and a little too fast for the town. So there's concerns about the kind of people that is coming. And we can only hope that it's gonna be more projects like us, where people are really interested in taking care of the land, taking care of the natural resources. I think the most important thing is that when you're coming to a new place, you can't just arrive and claim it as your own and do your own thing without considering the people around you. Especially in places like this where there's a local community that has been here for decades and decades. I think it's a matter of respect to the people that has been taking care of this land way longer than us. So I think the most important thing as someone that just arrived is to be part of the community and see how you can collaborate and work as a community rather than just arrive and do your own thing. I think it's amazing how the island has accepted us, has allowed us to build here, and it's a sense of hope of what future communities can look like. There's a really big opportunity for both worlds to collaborate on helping preserve this amazing island. It's so magical. Chacahua for me is this feeling of immense appreciation for nature and being extremely grateful that I have the opportunity to call this place home. I have a lot of friends that already have that idea of living in communities, you know, be reconnecting with nature and working with what the land can give you. So I would love this place to be like that. As far as for myself and for my brothers, this is the way of life that we've been looking to have for a long time. So being here is that sense that we're doing it. We're actually pulling the trigger. Little by little, we're gonna attract people that are really willing to just live in a more simple and natural way. Everyone can really find these ways of life. If it's something that you're truly aiming for, it's doable. And it's realistic in so many ways. I would love to see more people like us that are young and conscious and that are eager to wake up more and more to be the ones that are hosting so we can have more places like this where we're really conscious about the land, that we attract people that are looking for that way of life. And, you know, if we put a little seed, then little by little we start growing this generation of people that are ready to change the world and the way we live.